morning, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Sending prayers there to Guatemala at about 11:25 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. There was a magnitude 6.2 earthquake there in the city of Nueva Concepción, Guatemala. 367 people reportedly felt this earthquake, and USGS gave it an intensity level of 8. Now, the Mexican seismological government station said it was off the coast of Guatemala. And they also have a magnitude 4.9 just a little while later. Here we have a Twitter post that was translated. It says, after a strong 6.2 earthquake and a 4.9, Nueva Concepción, Guatemala, Conred reports damage in 7 departments, 7 locations, I guess. Landslides, obstructions, Highway Antigua, Guatemala, to the capital. Damage to homes and power cuts in church. There is another Twitter post. This man is picking up some of the boulders from the road. This right here is one very large boulder that rolled out. I don't know if it's a highway or what. It looks like, too, that the highway cracked right there. There's a still captured from that video. You can see more rocks here. And a still of a crushed vehicle. And you can see the roof here. Another Twitter post showing the debris in the road. And another post of a wall that collapsed. You see the debris down there in the sidewalk. And another image, debris there, 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 and going down the road. And another image, one looks like a canopy, a metal roof that fell off and onto the car. More images here. It looks like the roof of the building collapsed, or could be a wall. You can see some trees behind here. And another Twitter post showing more damage. Yeah, right on top of the car. There's also a video here showing cracks that go through the wall and then up the stairs. All the plaster. A little blurry, but this is the stairs with debris on it. And another image. Evidently, it's from these villages that's listed here. Another road closed off, and then over here is the translation of the post. It says falling walls and structures. Landslides en route to Antigua, the Inter-American Highway, and I'm not going to try and pronounce the other names. Going to Google Earth, it's been a while since they've had anything this large. 2016, a 6.1. Up over here, 1976, a 7.5. So going in, zooming in to Google Earth, yeah, here's the location that USGS says the earthquake occurred. It was deep, 51 miles in depth. All earthquakes are measured from sea level. What we have here is the South American trench subducting under and moving towards the Caribbean. In 2017, there was a magnitude 8.1. Now, that was a rupture of the entire plate, meaning the entire plate cracked going down to the mantle of the earth. 97 reports on EMSE, this one 34 kilometers northwest from where it occurred, said that they were scared. All dogs started to bark. So that would be 21 miles northwest. Strong earthquake, very scared, woke us up. They were sleeping. They were 45 kilometers northwest, which would be about 28 miles. Felt something strong with replicas. You know, there was aftershocks. Another one was lightly sleeping, could not believe how powerful the quake was. Strongest in my 3 years living in Guatemala. This was no 5, we're talking 6. Another one said it sounded like a freight train Then some movement followed by a very strong jolt. Woke us up, two shakings of 2 to 3 seconds. It was strong. The bed shook me awake. The dogs were startled, barking quite a bit. Then they joined me in the bed. Yeah, they were scared too. This one here says it lasted 15 to 20 seconds. Another one, 15 to 20 seconds. Shaking was visible and lasted a few seconds, enough time to get up and walk to a safer place before it stopped. Yeah, very strong. Woke up in the hotel room in Antigua at 1:15 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Well, actually, I think that would be Eastern Standard Time, because it was 11:15 Pacific Standard Time. Walls, light fixtures, and belongings on nightstand were shaken. Lasted a couple of minutes. Heavy lateral shaking. Lasted about 10 seconds. No evacuation of the hotel was needed or requested. A rolling quake. Things fell over in my house. Very strong. Was too strong. Short but enough to get me out of bed. Strong shaking. Lasted about 2 minutes, they're saying there. 1:17 a.m. That would be Central Daylight Time. Let's see. Strong shake. Another one. Strong shake. Strong shake. Strong, long-lasting wave movement. Felt like a wave. I was lying down in bed upwards. Very strong and stretched out. Felt very strong in the capital city. Hit us long and hard, long enough to wake up and leave the bed, ready to run. They're lucky it was so deep. One mirror broke in my house. It was a good one. It waked me up. I was sleeping. A report from El Salvador said mild but intense in Holy Key. Another report from El Salvador, very strong shaking, kind of slow, but moved a lot. Very sensitive earthquake. The electricity cable swayed. The walls and furniture creaked. Two more reports from El Salvador. So that would be about 140 miles east. It says here was significant. Woke us up. It was short but quite loud. They heard it. More reports from El Salvador. Very long and felt enough to wake us up. So USGS has 3 earthquakes listed. Unless you want to count this one down here that happened before that. And that was a 4.4. We also got a 4.5 and a 4.1. The 4.4, 8 people said they felt that one. That was in El Salvador. The 4.5 was in Guatemala. 5 people said they felt that one. So here we have the felt reports. Over here is El Salvador. And there's what? Intensity level 8. Which means it shook for about 20 to 30 seconds. Damaged slight. In specially designed structures. Considerable and ordinary. Sustainable buildings with partial collapse in some buildings, great in poorly built structures, panel walls thrown out of frame structure, falling chimneys, factory stacks, columns, monuments, and walls. Heavy furniture overturned, sand and mud ejection, blow holes in small amounts, changes in well water. Persons driving the car would have noticed. More images of damage. It looks like we got a power line down here and along with some large boulders. Another car crushed. A daylight image of a car and debris from that one building. And images of them cleaning up the debris with a backhoe and by hand. There's one of the images. And another. And another. Yeah, cleaning up as they're carrying weapons just shows you, yeah, how dangerous, yeah, different things are, yeah, different parts of the world. Amazing. The fire department even came out using hoses to clean, the debris that came off the hills on the highway. Here they have traffic stopped as they push it down off the cliff over there, I guess. There is no reports of any injuries, but I'm sure there's people injured from falling walls and different things. Yeah, they are prone for large earthquakes, and they've had them in the past. Sending prayers to everybody there. What are your thoughts? Yeah, the cleanup, how fast they got out there is just utterly amazing. Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.